Good morning, all of you. Today it is the final lecture of the chapter First Fourier Transform. Okay, we have completed First Fourier Transform. As per your syllabus, in First Fourier Transform there is Radix 2 algorithm, then decimation in time, decimation in frequency, bit reversal process, problems on decimation in time and decimation in frequency. And obviously the butterfly diagram, which is the most important part. Okay, so today I'll be discussing the decimation in frequency algorithm of FFT, fast Fourier transform. So before that, let me share the screen. Okay. Pardon. So, decimation in frequency is just the opposite, basically, of decimation in time. How do I say this? Just the opposite. Because, you see, the butterfly diagram, we will be coming to the butterfly diagram later on. Let us first see the decimation in frequency algorithm. Okay, after that, while doing problems, it will be very clear to you, it will be crystal clear to you, why did I say that it is just the opposite. Yeah. Now, you see, in decimation in frequency algorithm, it partitions the DFT computation into even indexed and odd indexed inputs or outputs, sorry, odd indexed outputs, which can be computed by shorter lengths of DFTs of different combinations of input samples. Now, what does this statement mean? What is the meaning of this statement? This statement means that any big thing, when split into small things, becomes easier to handle, isn't it? Koi bada cheez, agar chote cheez mein tum usko change kar lo, okay, then wo aasani hoga kaam karne mein usko leke, isn't it? So the algorithm partitions this algorithm basically. Iska kaam kya hai? Ye decimation in frequency ka. Decimation in frequency ka kaam nahi ye hai. Ye total ek DFT ko तोड़ देता है into even indexed and odd indexed outputs, clear? Which can be computed by shorter lengths of DFTs. So those two individual DFTs, now you can calculate. So those two are shorter DFTs length, and it will be easier for you to calculate. It will be easier for you to compute of different combinations of input samples. Now, let us split the DFT formula into two summations. One summation has the sum of first n by 2 data points, and the second summation also has the sum of last n by 2 data points, because total DFT formula indicates up to n, isn't it? So here I am taking n by 2, n by 2. First n by 2 points, last n by 2 points. Clear? So you see xk equal to n by 2 minus 1, summation of n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, xn into total factor, plus summation of n equal to n by 2 to n minus 1. Understood? Last n by 2 points, that's it. So first n by 2 points, obviously, it will be starting from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. And the last n by 2 points, it will be starting from n by 2 to n minus 1. Then, this can be split into, you see, the first one, it is remaining as it is, n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, xn into total factor, plus the second part, I have done like wn in to the power n k by 2 into summation of n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, x of n plus n by 2 into wn to the power kn. This I have made a change, I have modified. Why I have modified? So that both the terms can have the same summation limits. Clear? Both the terms, you see in the second line, both the terms are having the same summation limit. This one as well as this one. Clear? Both are having the same summation limits. Okay. Now, you see Wn to the power kn by 2 or nk by 2, whatever it is equal to minus 1 to the power k. Okay, this we know previously. So therefore, xk equal to, if I take common, I told you, for taking common, for making the same summation limits for both the terms, I have made it, I have modified the second term in the previous second line. So here, summation n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, you take common. You see from here what you get, xn plus minus 1 to the power k, this is minus 1 to the power k, into x of n plus n by 2, total bracket, wn to the power kn. See, wn to the power kn is for the first term, wn to the power kn is for the second term. So, again, let us split xk into even and odd samples. Okay, so if xk is this, then what will be x of 2k? X of 2k means the even sample, and x of 2k plus 1 indicates your odd sample, isn't it? So x of 2k equal to summation of n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, obviously it will be a common part, xn plus minus 1 to the power k will be not present because it's an even part of the sample. So x of direct, it will be plus x of n plus n by 2 into wn by 2 kn. Clear? And x of 2k plus 1, it will be, obviously, summation limits will be same, xn minus of x of n plus n by 2 into wn to the power k, total into wn by 2 to the power kn. Okay. Now, since, you see, since wn square equal to w of n by 2, this is a property of the total factor. So, now let us define the n by 2 point sequences, g1n and g2n, as g1n equal to this x of n plus xn plus n by 2, this one, and g2n is this. Okay, so you see here, I have done into wn to the power n. Clear? Now, thus we get x of 2k is summation of n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, g1n into wn by 2 kn. And x of 2k plus 1 is summation of n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, g2n, wn by 2 kn. Clear? Okay. Now, see what I've written. The computation of sequences g1n and g2n according to the above equation and the use of these equations to compute n by 2 point DFTs are shown for n equal to 8 point DFT. So we have taken a 8 point DFT. Okay, n equal to 8 point DFT. Now, I'll show you how, you see, the basic computation diagram shows like, you see, this is the basic computation diagram for n equal to 8 point DFT. Okay. You can notice the inputs and the outputs. If you see, you'll see one thing, you'll see one dissimilarity from decimation in time algorithm. My day before yesterday's lecture, if you follow, you will notice I have introduced a term, or I have discussed a term to you called a bit reversal. And there I have said that inputs of decimation in time are in bit reversal order, but the outputs are in natural order. Yes or no? Here you see, here you notice better. The inputs are in natural order. You see, x0, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, and x7. But you see the outputs, x0, x2, x4, x6, x1, x3, x5, and x7. So what does it show? What does it show? It shows that decimation in frequency algorithm is just the very opposite of decimation in time algorithm. Okay. Initially, I told this term. You see, the inputs are in serial order, in natural order, but the outputs are in bit reversed order. The outputs are in bit reversal order. Okay. So, this is way how we calculate the decimation in frequency. It's just the opposite. If you know decimation in time, you can do decimation in frequency. There is no extra calculations involved. the same process, same way to do, just the reverse. Just the reverse. Or you can say, input for decimation in frequency is the output for decimation in time. Or output for decimation in frequency is the input for decimation in time. Okay, it's a chain process. Clear? So you see the diagram. You can say it's a butterfly diagram. You can say it's a basic computation diagram also. The butterfly diagram is there. I'll be showing you later on. It is there. After this diagram, I'll be showing you. Or better, let me show you the butterfly diagram. That will be better for you. Just wait. You see, this is the butterfly diagram for n equal to 8 point. You see, it's written 8 point DIF. DIF means decimation in frequency. 8 point DIF algorithm is shown in the figure below. You see, the inputs x0, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, and x7. Yeah. And you see the outputs x0, x4, x2, x6, x1, x5, x3, x7. Clear? Now you see, obviously, the number of stages, how many stages the butterfly will have? It will be having 3 stages. Why 3 stages? Log n to the base 2. N is the number of samples. So it's the 8 point DFT. So log 8 to the base 2 gives you 3. Okay, so there are 3 stages. But you see, the stages, as you have seen in decimation in time, it's just the opposite of decimation in frequency. Clear? In decimation in frequency, you see, stage 1, it is just the third stage of decimation in time for 8 point DFT, 8 point DFT. So x0, x1, x2, x3, these are not having any backward paths. x4, x5, x6, x7 are having backward paths. And minus 1 is multiplied with the horizontal path. So in the before stage 2, with x4, x5, x6 and x7, we will be multiplying the Tudel factor. We will be having the Tudel factor in these 4 values because they are having the backward paths. Clear? So W80, W81, W82, W83. Clear? Now for stage 2, obviously, here you see x0 and x1 forward path. X2 and X3 are having backward paths. Here also, X4 and X5 forward paths, X6 and X7 are having backward paths. So X6 in the before entering into stage 3, X2 and X3, and here X6 and X7 will have Tudel factor multiplied with them. So 0 and 2, W80, W82. Here also W80, W82. Clear? And in the third stage, individual 2 values will be conducting butterflies. So in the first stage, there will be 1 butterfly. In the second stage, there are 2 butterflies. In the third stage, there are 4 butterflies. You see, 1, here 2, here 3, and here 4. So which terms are having your backward paths after the third stage? After the third stage, your backward path is present in X1, in X3, in X5, and in X7. So with all these values, we are having W80 multiplied at the output side. Okay. And then we are getting the final output. One thing you notice, I'll be discussing the differences between the differences and similarities both. Between DIT, means decimation in time, and the decimation in frequency. But let me tell you in brief that initially I have already told one difference, that in decimation in time, the inputs are in bit reversed order, but the outputs are in natural order. Here, you see the inputs are in natural order, the outputs are in bit reversed order, that you've already seen. Now, one more thing you'll notice, in decimation in time algorithm, the Tudel factors are multiplied first, and then the output is achieved. Here, you see, after getting the output from butterfly, we are multiplying the trivial factor and getting the final value. Okay, this will be more clear to you when I'll be showing you a problem using decimation frequency algorithm. Here, so you see at the end of this diagram, it's written from the above figure, it is found that the input data xn operates in natural order, but the output operates in bit reversed order. It is also noted that the computations are performed in place. Okay, now come back to the point. So this was the basic diagram. Now, what has been done in this diagram? Means in that diagram, basically, same. That is the computation diagram. The diagram that I have discussed right now. That is that which is printed from the book. It is the butterfly diagram. Totally the butterfly diagram. So here you see here n equal to 8 point DFT is broken into 2 n by 2 equal to 4 point DFTs. So the basic butterfly operation is like this. You see. That's what I have told you. The trivial factor will be multiplied after the operational product. So here you get to see this. You see the inputs small a, small b, outputs capital A, capital B. Obviously, there is the butterfly. You can see the normal directions are given as it is given in DIT also. Minus 1 is multiplied with the b part. Fine. Now you see Wn dash. Wn dash is the trivial factor and it is given where? In DIT, it is given in this point. The trivial factor. Remember the diagram, or you can reverse the page and you can see later on. But here in DIF, the trivial factor is given in this part, at the output part. So the total expression for B gets changed into A minus B into Wn. You see, A is capital A is A plus B, and capital B is A minus B into Wn, because Wn is both with A and B and after the operation of AB. So A minus B total into Wn dash. Okay, so this is the basic butterfly for DIF. Clear? So the process can be repeated through decimation of n by 2 point DFTs. Total process, you see, log n base 2 stages of decimation. Each stage has n by 2 basic butterflies. So n point DFT via DIF requires n by 2 log n to the base 2 complex multiplications and n log n to the base 2 complex additions. So now one problem using DIF, you see. What is written? Compute the DFT of the sequence xn equal to cos of n pi by 2 where n equal to 4 using DIF FFT algorithm. Okay, see, n equal to 4, obviously n equal to 4. So n equal to 4, so xn is cos of n pi by 2. So n equal to 4 means the value of n in cos n pi by 2 should be 0, 1, 2, 3. Only then we can say n equal to 4 samples. 4 samples means it will be starting from n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. So if n equal to 0, then cos 0. N equal to 1 means cos pi by 2, n equal to 2 means cos pi, n equal to 3 means cos 3 pi by 2. So cos 0 gives your value 1, cos pi by 2 gives your value 0, cos pi gives your value minus 1, cos 3 pi by 2 gives your value again 0. So our xn comes out as, the input sequence comes out as this. Xn equal to 1, 0, minus 1, 0. Clear? Now, Wn to the power k, trivial factor, W4 0, n equal to 4, so that W4 0, W4 0 is 1, and W4 1 is minus j. This is, we know, previously. Now come to the butterfly diagram. So, first of all, tell me, how many stages will this butterfly diagram have? It will have 2 stages. Why 2 stages? N equal to 4. So log 4 to the base 2. Gives us 2. So there are 2 stages in butterfly. 2 stages of butterfly. Initially, I have written the inputs in natural order, you see. I have written the inputs in natural order. You can notice. Serial. X0, X1, X2, X3. 1, 0, minus 1, 0. I have named them as capital ABCD. And this is the stage 1. A to C, B to D, C to A, D to D. So C and D are having backward paths in stage one. So W40, W41 present with C and D path. So W40 is 1, W41 is minus J. Here in stage 2, again individual 2 butterflies. Okay. So A1, B1, C1, D1 input for stage 2. So B1 is having the backward path, D1 is having the backward path. So X2 and X3 will be multiplying the total factor for getting output X2 and X3. We'll be multiplying the total factor for getting the output of X2 and X3. Not for X0 and X1. For X0 and X1, we don't need the multiplication of total factor, because X0 will be, X0 is what? A1 plus B1. X1 is what? C1 plus D1. But X2 is A1 minus B1 into W4. X3 is C1 minus D1 into W4, means W4. Okay, so you see, output of stage 1, A plus C, obviously. This one, at this point, it will be A plus C. At this point, it will be B plus D. At this point, it will be A minus C. At this point, it will be B minus D. So, A plus C, B plus D, A minus C, B minus D. Clear? So we are getting 0, 0, 2, 0 as output for stage 1. Now for input of stage 2, A1 and B1 will be the same as the output for stage 1. But C1 and D1, with output of stage 1, this one, output of stage 1 at this part will be multiplied by 1. And output of stage 1 at this point will be multiplied with minus j. Output of stage 1 at this point will be multiplied with minus j. Clear? And then you will get input of stage 2, that is B1. So A1 is like the output of stage 1, same. In B1 also same. C1 will be 013 into W40. And D1 will be 014 into W41. So it's 0020. Clear? Now our input, this is the input for stage 2. Means we have got A1, B1, C1, D1. Now we have to get X0, X2, X1, X3. Now you see, X0, obviously A1 plus B1, I told you. X2, what it will be? A1 minus B1. X2 is also C1 plus D1. And X3 is C1 plus D1 into minus 1. Okay. So we get XK equal to 0, 2, 0, 2. So this is the output. Okay, one thing, I'm just making a change. I've written mistakenly here. I'm just making a change. You see one thing, this part, this will be equal to x2. Okay. This will be equal to x2. Okay. I've written it mistakenly. Sorry. And this one is okay. This one is also okay. This one will be x1. Sorry. I've written mistakenly. Just, you see, this will be x1. Okay. You see, you can see from the diagram itself. Just, there was a slight mistake while my writing. Okay. I've written. So now accordingly, you can understand. Now you see, in the butterfly diagram, our this one, x0, it will be a1 plus b1, x2 is a1 minus b1, x1 is c1 plus b1, x3 is c1 minus b1. Okay, so now you see. See, x0, a1 plus b1, x2 is a1 minus b1, x1 is c1 plus b1, and x3 is c1 minus d1. It's okay. Just change x1 as x2 and x2 as x1 for the output. Okay. Then you'll be getting the values. And these are the values, 0 to 0 to. Clear? Okay. Now, this is the annotation basically. So let me rub the annotation. Okay. So I have omitted. So kindly make the change. I'll be making my change in the note, and then I'll be sending the comprehensive note of FFT, because this is the final plus for FFT. According to your syllabus in FFT, the portions that we have, so we are completing today itself. So I'll be changing in my note and I'll be sending you. But since there is a slight mistake, so get noted. Okay, it's a very minor mistake. I hope you understand. So remember, in DIF FFT algorithm, so input data xn occurs in natural order, but output occurs in bit reversal order. Clear? So this was the 8-point DIF algorithm that I've shown you. You see? Clear? Okay. Now, come to the comparison. It may come in the exam sometimes. What is the difference between DIT and DIF algorithms? So what is the difference? You see, both algorithms, they have some similarities also, not only differences. And some differences. So both algorithms use divide and compare method of computation. Both of them require n log n to the base 2 operations to compute the DFT. Both algorithms can be done in place. Both need to perform bit reversal at some place during computation. Okay. Means bit reversal is present, whether it is present in the input side, whether it is present in the output side, it is present. Okay. Now come to the differences. You see, for DIT FFT algorithm, the input is bit reversed, but the output is in natural order. In DIF FFT algorithm, input is in natural order, while the output is bit reversed. Now, what about the second difference? The DIF, that is the decimation in frequency butterfly, is slightly different from the DIT butterfly. In DIF, the complex multiplication is done after the add-subtract operation. What is this complex multiplication? Remember, I told about the dual factor multiplication. So this dual factor is multiplied after the add-subtract operation. But in DIT, it is done before. Okay, it is done before. The dual factor is multiplied before the add-subtract operation. But here, the dual factor is multiplied after the add-subtract operation. Clear? Okay. So these are the two differences and similarities. Basics. Clear? So this is not present in your syllabus, computation of IDFT, that is a inverse discrete Fourier transform using FFT algorithm. So in general, IDFT, we know xn equal to 1 by n, the summation of k equal to 0 to n minus 1, xk into 2 del vector. So here, n into x star n equal to summation of k equal to 0 to n minus 1, x star k into wnk. What is this x star n and x star k? These are the complex conjugate. Okay, complex conjugate of xn and xk. You see, the 2 del factor here, initially it was written wn to the power minus nk. Here it is written wn, w to the power nk. So here, this is the, here, final value of IDFT, xn. Okay. Okay.